The registrar and the consultant are busy examining the patient, and they ask you to call the general practice and find out the details about his medications. So you call the GP, who's maybe behind a curtain or something, and he tells you that, so you start. Basically, this is the entire section I'll show you. This is for all the regular medications. This is only PRN, as in when the patient asks. And this is once only, because if we want to give any medications that not PRN and it's not regular, like PRN morphine, just for this one time.
What is PRN for?
As required.
Okay, yeah, PRN as required. Okay. So, first, you mark the allergies. You ask about the allergies, they'll tell you this patient, so-and-so name. So you fill up the name, the family name, the MRN of the hospital. Male, female, all these details you fill in first. Then you ask about any allergies. Suppose they say penicillin. You write down penicillin. You write what type of allergy, if it's anaphylaxis or is it just an itch or a GI upset, and you sign there. You sign this, you print your name, and you put a date. Okay, that's just to cover the basics. Next, you'll have this medication, like suppose it's a medication that has a variable dose, like prednisolone. So 10 on one day, 5 on the next day, 10 on one day, 5 on the next day. Or gentamicin, because you have to change it based on the drug levels in your body. So 320 one day, 420 another day. So that's why you put in the variable dose of the medication. So you put in the date, suppose it's 5 or 3rd. You put in the name, prednisolone, route per oral, frequency. Now, this is suppose once daily, so you put down daily. And put down whatever indication you're giving it for. Suppose it's asthma or put your sign, put your name. And here you write down the dose. So this is a date. You put in a date here. 5th or the 3rd. And the dose being 10 milligram today, yeah. 5 tomorrow, 10 milligram today, 5 tomorrow. So it changes. You don't even have to enter all of these. If you enter 2, and the next day you're like, okay, maybe he needs 15. So you put down 15. So this is for a dose that changes every day. Okay? Because here you don't have to write the dose here. Tell you about this later. If it's a normal medication, like an anti-lipid reagent, like atorvastatin, okay, or an aspirin. So you write down the medication here. Medication is a generic name. Don't write Lipitor. If you do write Lipitor, in the bracket you have to write this one. Okay? Again, you put in the date, the route per oral, 40 milligrams, suppose you give it once a day or at night, so nocte, and you put in the time here. Okay, this is the time where you put it in. And this sign, this is going to be a constant dose every night, so you don't have to worry about it. Once you've entered it, this is what they're going to give them. Suppose it's aspirin, again, you put in the name of the medication, the dose, the frequency, all this in, another time. You suppose you want to give it twice a day. Then you write it twice a day. So recommended timing. So if it's a medications only once in the morning, you write down mane, 8 o'clock. If it's nocte, put down either 6 o'clock or 8 o'clock. If it's twice a day, then it's called BD. And it's 8 o'clock and 8 o'clock in the evening.
You mean you will mark here so that they will...
No. So you use this to put in timings. So you know what? So you don't have to write everything. It's nocte. If you forget to write this, at least you know nocte is either these times. But you write that, you write it here. Suppose it's QID, then you see, okay, what's the most appropriate timing? 4 times a day, 6 hourly, 6, 12, 18, 24.
That's a reference.
So that's just a reference, yeah. You can put in the timings like that. Okay, so all the normal medications you put in like this, and you put
Sorry,
it here.
If you have, for example, 4 doses a day, you would write the timings here in the vertical manner,
yep.
Right?
6, okay. 12, 18, 20.
Okay.
They put 22 because you don't want to wake up the patient. You can write QID or you can write 6 hourly.
Okay.
Yeah?
So these are the daily medications.
Yeah, these are the daily medications that they take that are regular medications.
But if you write the time here, doesn't mean that you gave the medication to the patient?
No. So this is for that. So suppose this is today's date, the nurses will sign here. Give you the 6 o'clock dose. Or give it, or the patient refused. Fine, refused. Or the doctor said to withhold, so put a withhold sign. So that's not, you'll only be required to fill this up. Okay, so this is for all the regular medications, this is for the variable dose medications, Now, you put patients on DVT prophylaxis when they come in. So suppose they ask you to put a patient on DVT prophylaxis. Of course, they'll give you the dose. They don't want you to worry about it. Suppose it's like, say, you know, heparin. Then you write it here in VTE, venous thromboembolism prophylaxis. So write heparin here. You put in the dose. Suppose it's 5,000 units BD, and you enter it down. Okay?
So is it only for the heparin? Like
yeah, heparin, clexane, enoxaparin, any of the DVT prophylaxis, okay. If you're giving it for that. Okay, only for, yeah, it's marked here, VT prophylaxis only. Okay, and mechanical prophylaxis is those stockings, TED stockings. So you put TEDs down here. Here you put down clexane, so 40 milligrams. BD, so you put 0,8 and 2,0. Root is?
Subcut.
Yep. And you put in the date and you sign, printer name, blah, blah, blah. Okay. Variable dose, DVT prophylaxis, regular medication. Suppose it's warfarin. Now, warfarin is given for a lot of indications. Atrial fibrillation, DVT.
Prostatic.
Yep. So, again, you mark which warfarin. There are two types. So, suppose it's Coumadin warfarin, they'll tell you. And now the warfarin dose changes every day, right? Suppose you're adjusting a patient based on the INR. So you check today's INR. Suppose it's 1.8. So suppose you start off with 4 milligrams of warfarin, okay, on the 5th, and you sign here. They give it every day at 4 o'clock.
So okay? Is this a target INR?
That's the thing. So your target INR is between 2 and 3 most of the times. Yeah. Okay. So you put your target INR, 2 is 3. Mm-hmm. Indication, atrial fibrillation. Mm-hmm. Okay, and you sign and complete this box, and you start them on whatever dose they are on at home. Suppose it's 4 milligrams. Next day you do the level and you find, oh, it's only 1.1. So you bump it up. So you increase it one at a time, because warfarin, when you give it, the INR takes 2 days to actually pick up. Okay, so increase it slowly. So it's 1.1, you're not really worried that it's going to shoot up too fast, but still you try 5 milligrams. Can you sign? You repeat the warfarin INR level. It's 1.8. What would you do?
Keep five.
Okay. Maybe you'll pick up. So yeah. Next, if it's when it's in the therapeutic range, you continue that. So every day you're supposed to fill this up, checking the INR, unless it's stabilized.
Are these filled on the morning rounds usually?
No, these are filled when patient gets admitted.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because their medications have to be charted.
Are you talking about the warfarin?
Oh, warfarin. Yeah. Yeah, so the warfarin can't be filled in the morning because actually, practically speaking, the blood results of the morning bloods come sometime in the afternoon.
Oh, okay.
So you fill them in then. It doesn't matter when you fill it. For the exam purposes, you fill it then and there because they'll tell you everything. They say warfarin, 4 milligrams, so that's where you know if to fill it here. They say, you know, clexane or whatever, and you fill it here. Okay?
Contacts.
No, contacts your pager number.
So they can. No.
If they do give you a pager, but they won't complicate it. I don't even remember if you had it. Someone told me they have it, and I saw the option to get this chart and show it to you. So I've done it. PRN. PRN is as and when required. So if your patient comes in with pain, and you prescribe endone, okay? So you write down endone here. Or if the patient comes in with nausea, vomiting, you write down ondansetron here, okay? But it's PRN. You don't need to keep on giving it to him every 4 hours or every 3 hours. So PRN is as required. So write down the indication, nausea and vomiting. Okay, dose is 4 to 8 milligrams.
Maximum.
And yeah, you want to give it every, suppose you want to give it 3 times a day, maximum 24 milligrams. So the nurses will give it to him. Suppose they'll give it, maybe you can put down 4 times a day. But the nurses will give it to him. They'll put in the date, they'll put in the time. And whenever he says, I'm getting nauseous, they'll give him an ondansetron. So they don't have to ask us. They can give it any time they want, as long as they make sure that the maximum dose isn't breached.
What else can be required?
Anything. Anything at all. Endone. Salbutamol, nebulizer, or morphine. But yeah, just anything that the patient may require. Painkillers, paracetamol, yep. Anything. Laxatives. Like Movicol or lactulose, if the patient is. Yeah. So these are just.
Right, yeah, sorry.
So endone. Endone is a painkiller. So again, suppose the dose is 5. And endone is a combination drug. So it's.
Oxycodone.
Yeah. And So it's 5 and 2.5 milligrams. Again, you want to give it 4 times a day with a maximum dose of, suppose, 20 milligrams or 30 milligrams.
So okay. Sleeping tablets also here.
Sleeping tablets. Now, yeah. The thing with sleeping tablets is you don't want to make a habit out of it. Mm-hmm. Okay? So when the nurse calls you, this patient is asking for a sleeping tablet. Now, if they're on regular ones at home, fine, you write it here. But if they're not, if they just can't sleep in the hospital, you write it here. Once only medication. So I go to the patient, like, you really can't sleep, you know, you assess the patient, and then you write down here, temazepam. Okay? Per oral, 10 milligrams, stat.
Stat, or, you mean only once?
Now.
Now.
Or you write down the time. So 5 on the 3rd at 21 hours. You know? So you can just give it once only. So this can't be repeated unless you actually come here and sign it.
Through all the admissions, it's only this time, you mean? Yeah. We cannot repeat it again.
No. This is once. When the moment you sign here, print your name, the nurse signs, it's gone. This cannot be repeated unless you write it again. Yeah, I can write it again. So the other night, if we can't sleep again.
And in the question, that was the question, write down the drug chart.
With renal
failure. So which phase we should write that one? In a patient, renal failure something, and they are here.
So suppose it's 1 gram, suppose once daily for 3 days. Okay? So 1, 2, 3, and you cancel this part out.
Okay. And in the second day, the patient got deteriorated, that we have to adjust the dose of the ceftriaxone.
If you have to adjust it, it goes there, but you don't adjust the dose of an antibiotic per se.
In case, we should have to write?
If you want to change the dose?
Just cancel it and write in another.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay. And if the patient doesn't have any allergy, what should we write?
Nil non. So just write there. Click on nil non.
No.
And you sign.
The meaning of the station is that you just don't copy paste the medication list into the chart. I think the station was in a patient with renal failure, so you as a copier.
So you as a doctor have to understand what medications might have renal toxicity.
So you need to review and ask your senior if this is.
So what you do is, suppose he has renal toxicity, then all the drugs that cause renal toxicity, you withhold. Or suppose, you know, this W. So suppose they give you gentamicin. Suppose you write it here. Or what is the other drug that can cause renal toxicity?
He was in diuretics and ACE inhibitors.
Yeah. So all those medications that you feel may cause problems, you have to wait. You have to do your creatinine levels and you check how bad the renal toxicity is and what the indication is. The patient is dying and septic.
I'll ask my senior if I need to change the dose. Maybe the examiner would answer, yes, you need to change this dose and then.
Yeah, you can. So like this is not worth 8 minutes of a station unless, you know, maybe it takes time to write everything. Unless, but yeah, if you're worried, if you say that the patient has had a stroke, for instance, you withhold it, saying, okay.
Come with a confusion, and he had a medication chart with him, and the task was to talk to your register about the medication and discuss the situation with him.
Okay.
So it is mainly from the ISPAR. I'll explain introduction, explain the situation, then fill up the medication.
So that's like a conversation you have with the patient. So every medication that he says, like the register won't tell you, you'll have a stem, right? These are the medications that the patient is on. So you check, like you use your brain for every medication. There may be some contraindications and some indication. Now, they don't expect you to know something that's way beyond the scope, but you need to know some basic things.
Yeah.
Okay, like the patient has come with a GI bleed.
Yeah.
Aspirin. So you wait, you think about
the
aspirin.
Patient, the drug's name, so far I can remember, they are diuretics.
Mm-hmm.
Digoxin, warfarin, and paracetamol.
Mm.
I found only paracetamol. I can continue on. The rest of them are like something.
So you talk
with
the registrar. I think that the patient has a background of this thing. Would it be appropriate to give this, or should I withhold this until I get the blood result?
Okay.
Withhold.
Okay. Just I will write the name and
withhold.
Withhold. Yeah. Yeah.
In Australia, is it any like website, the most common drugs? Like you said, it should be like a generic name.
Yeah. So okay, don't worry for the exam.
The same drug, it could be 120, but probably you've got to...
The list based on the patient's condition.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so just think very normally. If the patient comes with confusion or the patient is unconscious, you say, you tell the registrar, do you want me to withhold warfarin or any anticoagulations because he may have had a fall and had a bleed somewhere. So you talk to the doctor, and the moment he says go ahead, you can chat it down. So most of your case will be writing it down, mm-hmm. and the rest of it will be obviously reasoning why you're writing these things. So again, you know what the purpose of AMC exam is? You're a safe doctor. As long as you ask the questions, as long as you are concerned about certain medications, that's it.
So what was the recall you are
telling? I never ever touched this page here. But in case they do, this is for the paramedics. So suppose the paramedics have brought a patient in with complaining of chest pain and all that, and they've given him aspirin right now, or GTN right now. They write it down so you don't double up the medications. And this is a telephone
it's not
order.
The medication that the patient took?
No. Prior to presentation to the hospital.
Like in the
or if the patient says, if
he
I took
for example, his angina drugs before he came
you
to
can
the
write
hospital.
The pharmacy or someone can write it down.
No. Okay. Like on the way to the hospital.
On the way to the hospital.
Thrombolysis and things like that.
And if you, I'm covering 5 words suppose at a time and I can't get there in time for a medication. The patient says, listen, I'm feeling very nauseous. So you call the ward and saying, this is the name of the patient, this is the name of the medication, can you give it now?
Okay.
So you have to repeat it to 2 different nurses.
Pardon, can you repeat that?
This is a telephone order.
Okay.
If you can't be there at that time and you're sure that it's not a harmful drug like ondansetron, so I'll call them, the nurse will call me up saying, can I give this? So I said, fine, write it down. 4 milligrams of ondansetron to be given to this patient. The nurse will say, can you repeat this order to my colleague? Okay, so both of them will sign your nurse's initial 1 and 2. And then whenever you have the time within 24 hours, go and sign the order.